Hi, welcome to the lecture number 3. Welcome to the chemistry of acetals. Okay, this is the talk and chalk summary. Okay, we start explaining what is an acetal. An acetal basically is a carbon that is bonded to two alcohols. Okay? This is basically an acetal. How can be synthesized? Basically, we start with a ketone or an aldehyde. We treat it with an alcohol. And what we get is the acetal plus water. Okay, this is the general reaction. Okay, basically I am lying a little bit, this is an equilibrium in reality, but in order to force a reaction to go to the product, what we do is basically we remove the water of the final reaction. How we remove the water? Basically, we use an apparatus that is called a Dinnestark. Here we have the flask with the reaction. Okay. And okay, here with the flask, with the reaction, we heat this flask, and then here we have a condenser. And here is condensing the vapor, and what we get is that here we take the water. Okay, in this part of the apparatus, we take the water. That means what we are doing basically is removing the water that we are creating in the flask, putting the water in this part of the apparatus. This is how it works. Take in account that the colors that I use are not trivial. That means the oxygen that is formed, the acetal, these two oxygens, okay, are from the alcohols. Okay? In the ketone or in the aldehyde. We will see why in the mechanism. And the oxygen of the water is coming from the ketone or the aldehyde. Okay? Good. Now that we introduce what is an acetal, what we will do is basically the mechanisms of the formation. We will see the mechanisms of the formation of acetals. Okay? The formation of the acetals has two parts, okay? And all the chemistry that we will see is based in some aspect that we already know. For example, we start with this, where R1 and R2 could be carbon, could be hydrogen. In this case, will be, if one of them is hydrogen, will be an aldehyde. If both are carbons, will be a ketone. Okay? We have this. What we know about ketone? We know that we have a carbon double bond oxygen. That means that because oxygen is more electronegative than not the carbon, this will have a density negative charge, and the carbon will be a density positive charge. That means if we have a nucleophile, the nucleophile will attack here. Which is the nucleophile that we are adding? We are adding an alcohol, okay? However, the alcohol is not enough nucleophile to attack this. That means that we need to increase the electrophilia of this carbon. How we can increase the electrophilia of this carbon? Basically, the first step will be the protonation. We need acid in order to do a reaction. A pair of electrons of the oxygen will take the proton, and what we get is we have this protonated ketone, okay, that we can grow this resonance structure that explains better that this carbon becomes more and more electrophile. Okay, now, any nucleophile, even a very weak nucleophile, like is the alcohol, will attack this. Once we have protonated, once we have activated this carbon, simply the pair of electrons of the alcohol is attacking here, and what we get is we get this compound with a positive charge in this oxygen, in the oxygen of the alcohol. Next step, we remove this proton, and what we get is this compound where we add an alcohol and still we have OH. This is called a hemiacetal. And is the indication that we are in a halfway of the process. Okay? Good. What we need to do now? Okay, we know that in the final compound we have two alcohols, but we don't have any OH. We have to remove this OH. How we can do it? Basically, we know that a hydroxyl group, I explained you in the first and the second lesson, in the second lectures, that the hydroxyl group is by far a very bad leaving group, a horrible leaving group. How, in these cases, we improve this group in order that will be a good leaving group? Okay? What we do is to protonate the alcohol, making the alcohol water, and for this reason, because will be water, will be a very good leaving group. Okay? That means we protonate, we add acid, the pair of electrons is taking the proton, and what we have is this intermediate. Okay? Now, this water is a very good leaving group, that means that this will depart. Okay? And what we get this carbocation that could be in equilibria And this is up to you if you want to put the equilibria or you want to grow one of them. Basically, if you grow one of them, I am okay. Okay, this is an equilibria. The only that I did is put a pair of electrons to form a double bond to generate this resonance structure. Okay, these are two resonance structures that explain the same. This is called an oxonium ion. Okay, and like in the starting point, this carbon is very electrophilic. It's very electrophilic that a second molecule of the alcohol will be able to attack this carbon or the carbocation, if you want to see, if you want to say, both are okay. And what we generate is this intermediate okay, that we remove a proton. And what we get is the final acetal. Okay, this is the basic mechanisms. And what we can say about the mechanisms. First, we need acid. We need acid for two steps. We need the acid to activate the carbon of the ketone or the aldehyde, and we need acid to remove the water. Okay? But check. The acid that we add at the beginning to activate the ketone, we recover when we form the hemiaminal. Okay, that means we need one equivalent of acid. No, we only need catalytic amounts, superstechiometric amounts. Why? Because the one that we put at the beginning, we regenerate in the middle. Next thing, the acid that we add here in order to make the hydroxyl group a very good living group, what is happening is that we recover this acid in this point, at the end of the reaction. That means, again, the acid that we add in the first step from hemiacetal to acetal is recovered at the end. That means, again, we only need to add catalytic amounts of base. Okay? Good. This is basically the mechanism for the formation of acetals. And now we will do some different cases, or some cases that can create confusion, but in reality is exactly the same. For example, what happens if we are using a diode? Okay, we have our ketone, and now what we do is to add a molecule that has two alcohols. Well, it's exactly the same. The only difference is that we will have, instead of two molecules that are alcohols, we will have a molecule that has two alcohol groups. The starting point is the same. We need to activate this carbon. How we do it? Basically by protonation. Okay? And now, once we activate this carbon, remember we have the two resonance structures, the alcohol will attack the the peripheral electrons of the alcohol will attack here. And what we get is this compound. Okay, exactly the same that we did before. The only difference is that now the alcohol is slightly different. Okay? Then we lost the hydrogen, we lost the proton, and what we get is the hemiacetone. Okay, we arrive to the hemiacetal, a carbon with one alcohol and one hydroxyl group. Next step, we need to remove this alcohol group. How we do it? By protonation. Okay, a pair of electrons of the oxygen is taking the proton. And now that this is a very good leaving group, it's departing. And what we generate is the carbocation, exactly the same that we did before. What is the difference now? The difference is that one, we have this carbocation, or this oxonium ion, depending on the resonance structure that you grow. What is happening is that another molecule of the alcohol is attacking the carbocation. In this case, we have an alcohol that is already bonded to the molecule. That means that will be easier for this oxygen to attack the carbonyl group, attack the carbocation. And is what is happening, what we do. We generate this, and then simply we lost the proton, we lost this proton, and what we get is the final acetone. Okay? As you can see, it's exactly the same, but now the only difference is that the two alcohols are bonded in the same molecule. Only this. Okay? Next one. What happens if in the starting ketone or aldehyde we have already an alcohol? Okay, we will say, we will check it. Now what we will do is, what happens if in our molecule we already have, an alcohol, okay? Well, and we add, for example, methanol. Okay, the first step is always the same. We need to activate this carbonyl group. How? By protonation. What we get is okay, we get this intermediate, and now we have the oxonium ion. Now what is happening? We need to attack this carbonyl group by an alcohol. Which is the alcohol? Well, we already have one alcohol in the molecule, and we know that intramolecular reactions always are easier than not intermolecular reactions. That means that the most possible is that this alcohol will attack the carbonyl group. exactly the same that we did before with external alcohol. We do it with the alcohol that is already bonded to and we generate this intermediate. The alcohol bonded to the carbonyl group. Okay? Next step, the same as before, we lose the proton in order to make a neutral molecule. And what we have is this cyclic hemiacetal. Next step, well, what we did. We need to remove this alcohol. How? We protonate. Pair of electrons of the alcohol will take the proton. We generate this. And now, this is a very good leaving group because it's water. The leaving group is departing, and what we generate? Is the carbocation. Next step, the alcohol that we add is attacking the carbocation to generate this intermediate. We lost the proton in order to get the neutral molecule, and what we have is the final acetal. Okay? Again, the only difference in this case is that the first alcohol that we use to form the hemiacetal is the alcohol that we have already in the molecule. And why this is important? Because this is basically what happens when we have sugar. Okay, remember that sugar are ketones or aldehydes that have multiples OH. Okay, when we have the cyclic sugar, the glucose or the pyranose. Okay, basically what we are doing is a hemiacetal, or in the case of disaccharides, we have an acetal with the sugar, okay? Okay, finally we will do something that the formation of acetals, as I told you, is reversible. In order to don't make reversible, what we need to do is to remove the water of the reaction. But how we can do if we have an acetal? Okay, we have an acetal. For example, this with two methyls with two methoxides, and what we want to do is to recover the ketone. Basically, the only that we need to do is to add water. And what we will get is what we are doing is just the reversible reaction. Which is the mechanism? The mechanism is exactly the same that we explained before, but in this case, just the opposite. How we do it? Well, the reaction starts, we need to eliminate these methoxides and we need to put an oxygen.